And like all the other games, it's highly cinematic. Great game. I am pretty happy that I managed to beat Valus. I'm probably not gonna play Valus 3 for that long, because I do have another game. I have a third game that I'm going to be playing tonight, and that is Elysia Dragoon, and that is an awesome game. I'm gonna give that plenty of time. But yeah, the graphics here, fantastic. You know, the cutscenes. Yeah, I'll just kind of... We'll take in the cutscenes for just a second here. This is the way the game just starts out. But yeah, we have a third, completely different villain now. And he... Yeah, this Glames fellow. But this is cool. Yeah, check this out. We got a... it does a pretty cool little recap. Oh, no, I will be bailing at Ice World. But I just, yeah, but I do want to show off at least, like, the multiple characters. Yuko! Also, I think at this point I've been going a bit long. I'm putting on my anti-blue glasses. Oh yeah, the definitely not CV3 trio. Yeah, these are some of the blue blocker glasses I picked up actually not too long ago, very recently. But if I'm gonna be going for another 45 minutes, I'm putting these on because I don't like headaches, and I work in computers. My actual like job is in computers, so. I stare at computer screens a lot. But yeah, this is pretty cool. We get this nice cinematic recap of the first two games. Especially nice considering that we only got the SD version of the second game, but honestly, it's not a hard game to pick up. Like, I have to say, like, for Cid of Valus, SD Valus, whichever version you get, it's actually very easy to pick up. Like, very easy to pick up. It's not difficult to learn the bosses. Like, all I did was practice it, like, twice today, one time not all the way through, one time to speed it, and yeah, and you saw I was at the end and I still had 8 lives left. So if you practice the bosses a little bit, you have I've created my own strats, kind of, well, at least strats I wanted to use during a marathon, but I'm not using speedrun strats. Oh yeah, Kirby, yo. What would happen if Kirby, like gained the power of somebody like Megas? What would Kirby look like? That'd be kind of rad. But yeah, this is really nice. But now we're in Valus 3. Dark World will be absorbed into Netherworld. The king of the Dark World will abandon his world and try to invade the other worlds. Which, there again, we have kind of this tragic story for the enemies. It's not like, it's more complicated than bad guy bad because bad and bad. We have, maybe these actually weren't, they're just, like, desperate. They weren't evil, they're desperate. Lethus. Owned by Glames! These swords can destroy everything. Right? Just Kirby with a monocle. The bringing together of these two swords after millions of years. Can Yuko ever save the three worlds? We aren't gonna find out because I'm not playing the game through, because I'm definitely getting stuck in Ice World. All three are depending on Yuko's weapons. She only has one sword. Definitely not Simon. Definitely not a Belmont. Definitely not Sypha. Definitely, absolutely, definitely not Sypha. And then main character, MC. Cutscenes, more cutscenes. Champ, this is Yuko. Warrior of Valis. And man, this game control feels bad. Like, in a different bad way. My Valis sword has been stolen by somebody. I've got to get it back as soon as possible. I have to go now. Also weird to go through the dialogue in this game like that to make it go. You press start, which is weird. Okay, got it. But I can jump. No double jumps though. Sad face. My name is Shem. Good for you. May the power of the sword beat Glaives, and we cannot get to it in time. The human dreamland worlds are going to be... That's it! I finally found you! Someone's chasing me. I didn't think they would find me this quickly. Ah! Oh. Yeah, why did they put it on start? Yuko, help me. Oh no, I need the Valis sword. This is cool though. I mean, that's the thing, is like this, if this game didn't have these cool cinematic moments, like I would probably never play it. I mean, really, you're playing it for this cool cinematic. This is so cool. I mean, come on. This is pretty awesome. She jumps off a freaking building, man. And then powers up and flies back up. Pretty rad, in my opinion. Pretty rad. So, there's a dedicated slide button. It's the A button, at least to start with. Give me some MP. And, it feels about like the other games. You can't move very fast, but at least it's responsive. Feels responsive. The jump still sucks. And you have to hold up to jump higher, which I've never liked that in any game ever, but like, hey, every game from this era had it. Oops, I didn't get the heart fast enough. Stuff disappears real fast too. Oh man, I'm already missing. I really miss the double jump. Oh. Well, guess I'll die. On the first stage. Oh god, I should have probably practiced this game more than, like, a single time. I've been very busy. I actually just recently moved. Like, I just very recently moved. So, But I wanted to practice Cid of Valis because I do like the game. There's a lot of good to it. A lot of quality of life things, like I said. The fact that you can double jump, fire upwards, most pits don't kill you. I mean... You have to use your slide. You can look up. This meeting was done quickly. Do you understand why, Warrior Valis? Why did you do such a thing? Ask your sword! Okay. Also, being able to see your boss's, like, health meter also very, very cool thing. It's like, there's so many things that they did for SD Valis. I'm like, why didn't you do that for 3? Hi. Welcome to Segathon. Segathon 3. See, Valis Sword! The Dark Wars is going to be absorbed in Nether Space. This is true. Yeah, SD Valis. I of the entire series, it's probably the easiest to play, even though it does have the weird slidey physics and the floaty jump. It has a double jump, and you don't die when you fall into every pit except for the literally last level. Oh, an arcade stick. Nice. I have an arcade stick. I have a very nice Hori stick. It's around here. it's actually from a PS3, but it works as it's a USB cool. USB stick, and it's actually really good. Hori, I feel like, is one of the best like mid-budget brands for like stuff that will last, like decent controllers, but not as expensive as like the highest end stuff. Like the joystick, it's fine, it's good. It's good for what it is. But anyways, enough about that. Yeah. Yeah, oh yeah, Hori is a great brand. Especially if you wanna pay a little more, but you don't wanna pay like $500 for a stick. You can pay like $200 for a Hori stick and get a really nice one. Dreamland is being invaded by Glaim's army now. Well, where is Kirby? Dreamland? Alright, so now we can switch. I forget the button to switch. Nope, that's magic. I'm an idiot. Cool thing is, this magic sticks around. Okay, oh yeah, there is a timer too. What is it to switch
keep
characters?
Playing Sega, keep being cool.
Because now I can switch to Cham, and Cham is way better for a lot of reasons. Is it down and no, up? No, up. Okay, yeah. The slide button, that's right. The slide button is also the switch button, but yeah. Time to Castlevania this up. The whip is faster. It just feels better to use, to be honest. It feels way better. And it always has a nice long range to it. Whereas with Valis' weapon, not necessarily long range, so, alright. Yep, you can just glide over pits. And occasionally, you have to do that. That's a mechanic you have to use. I forgot to hold up when I was jumping. This game. But luckily, after this game, I will be playing a really, really good game. Yeah, I went long very purposely. I mean, I was like, you know, I messed up several times on playing SD Valis, but at least I made my way through it. But this game, I have no plans and no chance of finishing it, really. Well, Oh yeah, by the way, the items that appear, completely random. And I missed the jump. I hate the jumps in this game. You can jump high, but you can't jump very far. I'm not using an original Genesis controller. I'm using a Hyperkin. That's actually a pretty high quality one. It's feels exactly like the good six button controllers. So pretty happy with it. Yeah, every jump in this game is just nightmare. Go away! So that Prentice of Valen has been imprisoned in the Tower of Gold in the center of this lake. Are there any future for Dreamland? Hey, Boatman, we got to go to the tower. Give us a ride, please. Okay, but I suppose it's only for two people. One of you must stay. One person whom, if I go, I cannot be helped by Yuko. Which one of you will take the chance? Yeah, I'm going to go with Cham. Cham is much better on the boat. Mainly because she has reliable range. And the homing fire magic, very good magic, very nice magic. Yeah, I'm kind of taking no chances here, even in this auto scroller. Not gonna jump. For most, only jump when I know that it's actually safe and there are no enemies around because, yeah, hits done on this game. You see how far it knocks you back? It basically knocks you back the length of a slide. Why are you stopping here? I must collect professional deer beyond fair beyond this point. Ooh. Not that bad of a boss. This time it really behaved. It can troll you. There again, there's bosses in this game that can totally troll you. Okay, take the freeze magic for now, I guess. So the single swords raise your sword or your attack power maximum, while the double swords actually will make your attack power go up like go up way faster. So that's but you never know what you're gonna get because there's no set spawns. All right, thanks. So yeah, this though I do like the fact, I mean, even though it is obviously sort of like Castlevania 3, like inspired with the three characters that you can switch between, it's there are some minor quality of life changes between this and the first and second games, but also some bad changes. Yeah, having the slide also be your switch, I guess they didn't really have a good alternative. Oh great, you have nothing to say. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Alright. And there again, those are completely random. You never know what you're going to get. So sometimes they may be really kind to you and give you life all the time and magic. Sometimes they'll not. I do sometimes forget that the sliding in this game is levitation sliding. Oh yeah, if you notice also, like, Cham's whip here is actually has a really big hitbox to it, really nice, good, big hitbox. Are you Velna? My name is Cham. I've come with Yuko to rescue you. I do appreciate your help, but I think it's just a matter of time before Dreamland will be conquered by Glames. Where is Koli Lamba? What time is it? I expect he's on the roof of the tower. Right. So I'm probably only going to have time to kind of do this tower thing. Here's the spellcaster. It's cool that she has this, you princess, what do you think you're doing? Okay. Probably not going to beat him at this rate. The thing is, yeah, she's also really slow. That's the trade-off. She has a good range, but now she has... I lose the kind of upward shooting thing. That's going to make this battle a lot more difficult. if not impossible. I miss being able to shoot shoot projectiles like you can in SD Vallis. This time. Maybe I'll actually manage to make it to Iceland. Sutherland. By the way, you can do something in this level that actually you can do it in most levels. If your last hit, like the hit that kills you, is at the same time as you exiting a room, you still spawn in the next room, just with no life. However, it doesn't make you invincible, unfortunately. Alright. Alright, switching. Cham is just way better. So this part is kind of silly, to be honest. It's, you just have to ring the bell a bunch of times. Bell of Truth. Great. Finally, that was the Bell of Bravery. Oh! This level is just annoying. Be way easier. I also miss the bosses. After the bosses, getting your life refilled. That was nice. This time I did a lot better. But I actually have a clip where accidentally like take a last hit into that door, take a death hit into that door, and then I just spawned into this area with a zero life. Unfortunately, it didn't like, you know, underflow and make me invincible. I just could only take one hit. But that's the thing that can happen. The hit stun is so powerful it can even slightly keep you alive. That's Reiko, by the way. Let's get a little more magical power. I have like zero right now. Hey, life. This is Velna, I believe. But if you, one thing I forgot to do actually, I forgot the order in which they appear, but if you choose the character that's sort of linked with the character that appears, you actually get kind of a little bit of special dialogue. Like Reiko and Yuko have, I believe there is a special dialogue if I would have been Yuko when I met Reiko. Yeah, this is just a gauntlet. And because Cham can attack so fast, way, way better. Attack fast at range. And plus I'm pretty powered up right now. I've the walk up. But yeah, this is really boring. I mean, with so much they kind of like tried to do different on this game, they went with some really, really boring, like, with some of the bosses, really uninspired, especially considering that this is a game series which is really about the bosses, and this game does not have great bosses. And that's it, that's the boss. Ooh. Since I'm running low of time because I allowed Valis to go long, I'm going to switch over to just to give a little smidgen of Lacy Dragoon, even though I'm actually almost fully out of time, and next up we got, what do we have next up? Oh yeah, Better on SMS Showcase with Grimshims. I'm going to just switch over to Lacy Dragoon because I just want to at least show it off because it's such a awesome game. It's just so good. So here we go. Goodbye, Valis 3. Your ice physics are absolutely horrendous. Okay. There again, this is my Genesis here is a bit touchy. Doesn't always like to load. And nope, that didn't load.